Hello students, welcome back to our biology class. In our last class we were discussing the different reasons of outbreeding devices. That means what is an outbreeding device and why a plant has to go for outbreeding devices or has to adopt a means of outbreeding device, we were discussing in our last class. So in our today's class we are going to discuss what are the types of the outbreeding devices that a plant adopts or the plant wants to go for. Okay, so as you already know that this discussion is going on the chapter 2, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Okay, so let us discuss today the different types of outbreeding devices. Let us, in order to recapitulate or in order to recall, let us know what is outbreeding device again. So these are several devices or mechanism or any kind of processes which the plant adopt to promote cross pollination. That means it doesn't want to have self pollination, so it wants to have cross pollination, so the plant adopts these methods, okay, which are given below. So there are some devices or methods which are given below, or we will be discussing today in our today's class, which the plant uses in order to prevent self-pollination, and it wants to promote cross-pollination. Okay, it wants to go for cross-pollination, so it wants to take this kind of methods or devices. So we'll be discussing these devices in our today's class. The first is your unisexuality. Unisexuality is an outbreeding device in which the plant bears either male or female flower. Besides, the flower is not hermaphrodite, it is also called diecism. See what the plant does here. If the flower, it is going to have male and female both together, okay, so this is male and this is female part, suppose. Okay, if the plant is having this flower where male and female both are together, then chances there that this male will fertilize this female. Okay, chances there, understood? So chances there here. So in order to stop this, as the flower doesn't want self-pollination to occur, in order to stop this, what the flower is going to do, some plants, what they do, they go for only unisexuality. That means only male part is present in some flower, and in other flowers only female part is present. Okay, so now this flower doesn't have any other option, it will have to go and search a female flower stigma in order to fertilize. Okay, so here it automatically, you will see cross-pollination. Self-pollination will automatically not be there because the plant does not have both the male and female parts within it. Understood? So unisexuality is one of the technique or one of the method by which the plant goes for cross-fertilization. Or you can say it is one of the method of outbreeding device. Understood, students? Okay, so let us move on to the different second technique or second outbreeding device, which is your dichogamy. So what is dichogamy? In this outbreeding device, the stigma and the anther have different maturity times. Thus, depending upon the maturity, dichogamy can be classified into two types. So before knowing the types, let us know what is dichogamy. This is a method of outbreeding device, okay, where the plant, what it does, it settles or it sets different time for the stigma and anther maturity. That means, suppose this is a flower. In some flower, you already know both are present. Earlier we were discussing unisexuality where they are not present, but if they are present in both the male and female part are present in the same flower, this is male and this is female present in the same flower, what they are going to do is that in order to prevent self-pollination or in order to encourage cross-pollination, what they are going to do, they will set different times for the maturity of this male and female. That means the male sometimes may mature earlier, okay, early mature. And the female is not matured now. If the male is matured and female is not matured, how can this male go and fertilize this female? It is not possible, is not it? So the male pollen grains, it will have to go and search some other female matures. So that's why what it is going to do, it is going to go to some other flower because of this reason. Understood? Or you can also take the opposite example. Suppose this is male and this is your female. And suppose now female has matured earlier, the male is not at all matured yet. Now this female stigma is mature, it needs pollen grain, then only it can become, it will have fertilization and it can give birth to new babies. is not it. If its male is not mature who is staying in his home, it will go and have to search some other male. Okay? So what it is going to do, other pollen grains from other male flower will come and fall on this female. Okay? From other flower, from a different flower. Understood? So this, the plant, what it does by itself. It wants to do this. Because why? It does not want itself to get self-pollinated. Okay? Suppose if I am a flower, I have two parts, male and female, both the parts are there. But both the parts will not mature at the same time. If my androecium or the male part is getting matured now, my female part may mature 2 months later. Then what will happen? My male part, it is already mature. So it will have to fertilize some female, no? So it will go and search some other female in some different flower. Understood? And same thing can have the opposite also. That means, suppose if my female part of my flower is getting matured earlier, male is not yet all matured till now. So the female is waiting for somebody to come and fertilize it, okay? So that it can produce ovules. Understood? So what the female is going to do now, the female will be waiting and some other flower, it will come and fertilize the female part. Understood? So here you will see if it is dichogamy is there, automatically it encourages or it promotes cross-pollination. It promotes cross-pollination. Understood? That's why you can say that dichogamy is of two types, you can say. One is protoandry and one is protogyny. Protoandry in which is that in which the androecium matures earlier before the gynoecium. That means the male part is maturing earlier. That's why it's called protoandry. Okay, not protoandry. Protoandry means where the androecium is getting matured earlier. Understood? And the second one is your protogyny, where the gynoecium is getting matured earlier. Is it clear? That means before the androecium. That means the female part is getting matured earlier before the male part. Protoandry example is a maize plant. Maize plant is the example of protoandry in which the androecium is getting matured earlier than the gynoecium. Understood? So this dichogamy is a very good technique by which the plant goes for cross-pollination, and it is the second type of outbreeding device. So this was your first type of outbreeding device, number one, and this is your second type of outbreeding device. Now let us discuss the third type of outbreeding device, that is your harkogamy. Okay, what is harkogamy? Harkogamy is a naturally occurring condition where there is a natural physical barrier to entry the pollen grains into the ovaries. It is a natural method, okay, where what happens, one physical barrier will be there automatically in order to prevent the pollen grains from the ovaries. Okay, it is just similar to the protection techniques which human beings use. Understood? You might have heard about the different physical barriers or the protection techniques which human beings use, as for example condoms, which human beings use in order to prevent pregnancy. Okay, it is just like that. What it is going to do, the stigma, suppose this is your stigma of the flower, stigma, you know already it is the male, female part. The stigma, what it is going to do, it is going to cover itself. It is like some protection will be there over it. Okay, and for this reason, the anther or the male part of the same flower, it will not be able to fertilize it. Understood? So what it is going to do, this pollen grains, it will have to go to some other flower. Okay, and as soon as the pollen finishes here, no more pollen is left, now this flower stigma, it is going to remove its physical barrier. Okay, it will remove its physical barrier now, and it is open now. So now there are no pollen here in the in its own male part. So some other part males will come and fertilize it. So it is going to enhance or it is going to promote cross pollination. Understood? So harkogamy is another method which promotes cross-pollination. Harkogamy is a naturally occurring condition in which there is a natural physical barrier to the entry of the pollen grains into the ovaries. Understood? So this is the third type of outbreeding device. Now we are going to discuss the fourth type of outbreeding device, that is your self-sterility. Self-sterility. In this outbreeding device, the plant possesses a gene to recognize similar genes and doesn't allow the pollen grain to germinate. That means what here what happens in the same plant, they will have one particular gene, okay, that will recognize similar gene. Suppose this is a plant and this is a flower, this is the stigma of the flower, these are the androsiums, okay, these are the androsiums, this is the anther, here you will have the pollen grains, they have some gene present. I have already taught you about gene in our earlier classes. One gene is present and this gene is able to recognize that the gene coming from this anther, it is same because it is the same flower. Okay, since it is the same flower, the genes present in both the parts will be same. The genes present in both the parts are same, yes or no? Because it is the same flower, okay? It is like the same family. It can understand, okay, that this gene that is coming to me, it is of my own flower. So what it is going to do, it is going to prevent, don't come. You cannot come because you are from my same family. Understood? So it is going to prevent. In order to see this, you see this example here. See? Here in this flower, for example, in this flower, these are the anther and this is your stigma. Okay, these are the ovules. So what is going to happen here? The pollen grains, here the stigma, it is going to have some kind of gene. Suppose S1 and S2 genes are present. And if the pollen grains come to this stigma, it is going to prevent that don't come. Don't come to me because you are of my same family. And because of that reason, here the pollens cannot come. But in the second case, you see in the second diagram, these genes, what they are doing, they are protecting it from this own family, okay? That the pollen grains from this his or the flower's own anther cannot come to the stigma. But when wind is blowing, when this insect is coming, as I already told you, these are the two different means by which pollination occurs, through wind or by through insects. When they are coming, they are bringing pollen grains, you see. And these pollen grains are not coming from the same flower, okay? They are coming from different flower. So what this gene is going to do now, they are like security guards, okay? They will open the gate now. Oh, you are not from my same family, come. And this pollens will easily go and fertilize the ovule. So in this case, the ovule is completely protected so that its own pollen cannot come and fertilize it. But if it is coming from cross-pollination, that means this, if it wind is bringing, insect is bringing, that means it is not self-pollination, right? It is cross-pollination, from somewhere else it is coming. So then it is going to open the gate, that come and fertilize me. Understood? So this is called self-sterility. Self-sterility. Okay, students, so here what it is going to do, it is going to recognize its own similar genes and it will not allow the pollen grain to germinate. And also it will not give the pollen grain to come and fall there, okay? The self-sterile genes is present in ovules and in the grain. It is going to present, self-sterile genes are present in the ovules. Here also it will be present and here also in the grain also it is going to be present. If the gynoecium is mature now, here the gene, what it is going to do, it is not going to give the anther to produce the pollen grains. It will say that you don't produce the pollen grains. Your own sister is getting mature, okay? So this, they are like some brothers and sisters, okay? Although they are in the same part, they are in the same family. The flowers which do not want self-pollination to happen, they are in the same, they think themselves to be in the same family. They think that these parts are brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters cannot marry each other, okay? So they don't want them, their family inbreeding within them. Is it clear? So they want crossbreeding, cross-pollination. That's why what they are going to do, when this female is mature, they will tell this male that you don't produce your pollen now because your sister is mature, she is waiting for some pollen to come. And that's why these genes are going to do this work. Here the pollen will be rejected, but here the pollen is accepted. So this is all about self-sterility. Now let us discuss the fifth outbreeding device, that is your heterostyle. In this outbreeding device, the stigma and the anther, they are at different levels, okay, preventing the pollen grain to reach the stigma and pollinate it. If you see this diagram, you just see here, the anther, it is below and the stigma is long, long styled, okay. You can say that this is called style and this portion is called stigma. This filament is called style. Here you already know it is called anther and this is called filament. Understood? So this is the thalamus to which both of them are attached. Here you see the style is long. Anther is very, very short. So how can this anther go and pollinate this style? because of gravity, it is not possible for this anther to jump and fall on it. Understood? It is not possible. Okay? So this is called heterostyle. The style is completely at different level so that the pollen grain cannot reach the stigma, in order to prevent this pollen grain to reach the stigma. If it is present like this, if it is short style, then self-pollination may occur. You see, here self-pollination is possible. Self-pollination is possible. But here only cross-pollination is possible. Understood, students? You just see here. Here the anther is at higher portion, higher level. If wind blows or if the pollen grains are mature, obviously it is going to come and fall here. That means these flowers, they want themselves to get self-pollinated. So they have arranged it like this, okay? They want themselves to get self-pollinated. So they will arrange their anthers and style like this, so that this pollen can easily come and fall and it can make this ovule fertilize. But they don't want, this style doesn't want, okay? They doesn't want because of this reason, the style is so long. The pollen grains cannot go from here to here because of gravity it will fall downwards only, okay? It is not possible. And because of this reason, what will happen? Some other bee or some wind will come and it will blow away the pollen grains from here. Understood? And this stigma, it will get fertilized by some other pollens which is not from this flower. Is it clear to all of you? So, if the style is heterostyle, then what happens? Then also the plant gets cross fertilization. So it is fifth type of outbreeding device which the plant adopts in order to go for cross fertilization. Then your last type of outbreeding device, or sixth type, is your pollen prepotency. Okay, pollen prepotency. In pollen prepotency, a different flower's pollen matures faster than that of the same flower, thus helps to prevent autogamy. It is also like this. Different times I told you, like they have some different times in order to fertilize their flower. So what in this case, what is going to have? The pollen is going to get, it is not going to get matured first, okay? In the pollen prepotency, what is going to have? A different flower's pollen. These two flowers are there. This is one flower. They have a male and female part. This is another flower. They too have male and female part, okay? So here this male part is not going to mature first. It will wait. So what is going to have? In the same plant, but some other male flower, male part may get mature. So what is happening? Here cross-fertilization will happen. Is it clear? Understood, students? In pollen prepotency, a different flower's pollen will mature faster than that of same flower. Thus, it will help to prevent autogamy. Autogamy means self-fertilization. So this is going to enhance or promote cross-fertilization. Is it clear, students? So these are the different methods by which a plant goes for outbreeding, for cross-pollination, or you can say outbreeding. The word inbreeding means self-pollination, okay? The word inbreeding, it means self. And the word out means cross. It's simple logic, okay? The word in means self and the word out means cross. So these are the different methods by which the plant goes for outbreeding or cross-pollination, which we call as outbreeding devices. The first one is your unisexuality. Second is your dichogamy. Third is your hercogamy. Fourth is your self-sterility. Then fifth is your heterostyle. And sixth is your pollen prepotency. Understood, students? I hope, students, you have understood what are the different types of outbreeding devices, along with in our last class that we were discussing that what are outbreeding devices and why a plant wants to go for outbreeding device. So this is all about outbreeding device in the chapter 2. I hope, students, you have understood this well. We will discuss a different topic in our next class.